From a young age, this fisherman's life revolved around the ocean. He saw his father going to the sea every day, and his mother made him these origami fishes with coconut leaves. And to this day, the waves and the fishes are the elements that define his life. Inspired by everyday life, this series is called The Humanscape. It started out as these simple line drawings in my sketchbook, and it's developed into an ode to the common man from different cultures of India. Kochi holds a special place in my heart. It is my birthplace, and I always wait for an opportunity to go back. It's known for its beautiful backwaters and nature, but it's the people, especially the fishermen, that really intrigue me. When I stumbled upon this fisherman by the beach at Fort Kochi, I was fascinated. His attire, lifestyle, challenges, and most importantly, the simplicity of his life caught my eye. And I made this really quick sketch on my sketchbook, and when I showed it to him, I still remember that smile on his face. And right after that, he shared his story with me. And I had to capture that story on one of the walls in Fort Kochi. The sketchbook, it's always on me. It's like a space where I can be myself. Like, I can draw whatever I want. Why is it such a prized possession? Essentially, it is a testimonial to my journey as an artist. Vincent Van Gogh once said, "My sketchbook is a witness of what I am experiencing, scribbling things whenever they happen." Let me tell you a small story. On my first day in Bangalore, I noticed this traffic police patrolling around on his bike. The first thing that caught my attention was his massive white hat. It almost made him look like a stern cowboy from one of those Hollywood films. And right after that, my mind started to visualize this series of transformation of this very ordinary personality into a modern-day personality, and that's when I made him dab. Is there anyone who doesn't enjoy traveling here? Man, I love traveling. Airports, railway stations, and bus stands are the best place where you can find diverse characters. And flights are the most peaceful place where you can find your models. Don't get me wrong. Models aren't just, you know, like passengers staying still or maybe sleeping. On one such flight journey, I started sketching a man sitting next to me. Initially, he was a little creeped out because I was constantly observing him. But later, when I was done with the sketch, I showed it to him. And the man was pleasantly surprised. He took the sketch and he showed it off to his family traveling with him, including his toddler who could barely speak a word. And I saw their reaction. I was so happy that I actually offered him the sketch to keep. And in return, he tried to give me some money. But I politely declined, but that would have been the fastest money I could have made. A huge part of art visualization is creativity. But there are times when you wake up and your sketchbook pages just blankly stare back at you. And this happens to the best of the artists out there. For me, the answer has always been travel. When I feel saturated, I pack my bags and I leave. I go to a new place, meet a lot of new people. And they all have like beautiful stories to tell me. I collect all of those stories, put them in my sketchbook, come back, and I'm all set to start my next series. Rajasthan, the land of kings, is known for its vibrancy, rich culture, and of course, the scorching heat. So while I was there, I came across a lot of local people, especially the folk musicians. So let me quickly show you a clip.
Thank you. अच्छा बनाया आपने ये पेंटिंग, सो थैंक यू, इसलिए आपको बहुत
थैंक यू.
But yeah, I was so fascinated by their colorful turbans. But somehow I got myself a black turban. So while I was exploring the Jaisalmer fort, I met this old man. And the first thing he asked me was, why are you wearing a black turban? And I replied, black is my favorite color and I think it looks cool on me. And the man explained how every color of the turban represented a state of mind. Like bright and vibrant colors are worn to express joy and happiness. And it was worn during beautiful celebrations, especially the monsoon celebrations. And dark and dull colors are worn during sad occasions like funerals. So I was so fascinated by how colors were used to express certain emotions. And I had to capture that through this painting. Oh, that was me back in the day doing my thing. I love that picture. So yeah, colors have been a part of me from a very young age. But though you may have noticed, most of my artwork is a base of black and white. But I like to add a small burst of color just to, you know, like bring in the viewer's attention to certain subjects of the art. I think a single color can change the entire context of the scenario. Like for example, this piece is titled The Hell Club. It represents a brutal fight between two rival groups, and red is being used to symbolize destruction. Storytelling is absolutely everything for me. Like, every moment has a hidden story in it. But we're all so caught up with our life that we forget to appreciate the simple things that keep us ticking. But I love to view life through the eyes of the common man, and documenting simple everyday life through art. Art is a way of connection and communication between people who meet serendipitously in their own journeys. I believe that the art is not complete when you're done doing it. The art is complete when people see it and are able to enjoy and connect to it. I've always believed in the voice of the streets. And the pieces that I enjoy doing the most are street art pieces. I find that street art brings people together. We all tend to assume that art is meant only for large galleries and museums, but art is truly all around us, as captured in this picture. This is a digital art that I did based on the culture and history of Kochi. It showcases a melee of Kerala's rich culture and history through the lens of time. As you can see, the fisherman holding an hourglass in the middle frame. From art, music, colonization, and a lot more in like three distinct frames. Sorry. So yeah, in the years that art has been with me, I've realized that it's an active choice you make. There is this discipline in art that can lead to extraordinary visions coming to life and can break barriers in a way that can't be anticipated until it's actually complete. Remember, art has always been an evolutionary practice. And this is for all the artists out there. I want you to know that I see you and I acknowledge the artist in you. You have a gift and it's up to you to make the most of it. How you share that gift with the rest of the world is what sets you apart as an artist. So go on there, show the world what you are made of, and do it with a big smile on your face. Thank you so much.